So welcome, my dear and friends. Now we'll discuss about condensers and curriculums. This is unit 1, condensers and as well as cooling towers. So here we will see that what is that condenser and what is that cooling tower. So both we will discuss. So why we are discussing now cooling towers. So in the steam power plant, we discussed about the cooling towers. Okay, cooling towers as well as condensers. Okay, actually this was our, we are already studied in the thermal engineering. Again, we are repeating once again. So here today we'll discuss about the introduction of condensers and cooling towers and the types of condensers, sources of air in the condensers, and the effects and the air leakage. Okay, effects and air leakage. Okay, next, the methods of obtaining maximum vacuum condenser and the vacuum and condenser efficiency. So another one is that mass of cooling water required inward air pump, necessity of cooling parts and cooling towers. This is our main subject. Condenser is one of our semi topic, but actually our main topic is cooling ponds and cooling towers. And without condensers we can't go for this cooling towers. And the condenser water cooling systems and the types of cooling water and cooling towers and cooling ponds. So now we'll go for the introduction of the object to object condenser. So in that, to create a low back pressure from the turbine exhaust, so we know that Rankine cycle. What is that Rankine cycle? There will be one boiler room there. From boiler to, the steam is generated, and then the steam is passed, or it is sent to turbine. Okay, general, I am speaking the general cycle. So after that, it goes to mechanical work, and then whatever remaining steam is sent to that the steam is sent to that condenser, and then condenser to one feed pump. From that feed pump, we are going to sending to that hot well, and from hot well to, we are going to sending to that again one more feedback pump, and it is goes to that economizer, So from that economizer, again we will send to that boiler. So this is that Rankine cycle. Now, so in that Rankine cycle, now we will see that PS diagram. Okay, now what is that? Here is that we are going to taking PV diagram for this one, and pressure and volume diagram. See that the inlet, the pressure P1 is enters, and it isentropically it is sent to that pressure P2. Okay, and it is traveled 1 1 2 2 and 2 2 3 3 2 4. So 3 is equal to 2 is equal to 3, 1 is equal to 2. So over there we are going to circulating entire that atmospheric pressure. So here clearly we mentioned that turbine inlet P2 and turbine outlet P3 and goes to again boiler is that we can say that P4, P1, P2, P3, P4. Okay, that is that our Rankine cycle. So what is that advantages of this Rankine cycle when you see that PV diagram, that is increases the work done per kg of steam, increases the work done per kg of steam, increases the thermal power plant by using this thermal efficiency. Condensed steam provides a source of good pure feedback water, and high temperature condensate water reduces amount of heat supplied per kg of steam, reduces the corrosion boilers tubes. So that is the advantages. So what are the elements of the our power plant? Okay, so what this condenser is required? I told first condensing plant is required. Condenser first, what is the definition of that condenser? Condenser is nothing but that we are going to condensate that steam into that water. So that condensed steam, the cycle is going to converting into that water. Okay, that is that condenser. Condenser means to condensate that steam into that water. Okay, that is that main function of the condenser. Condensate means, so it is going to be converting that hot steam, super saturated steam, we are going to converting into that ordinary water. So means that don't think that that is a 50% of steam will be there, 50% of water will be there. That is a wet condition. So that process we seen that earlier videos, and supply to that this water we are going to supply to the cooling water, and condenser cooling water pump will be there, one feed pump will be there. With the help of that pump we are going to sending over there, air extraction pump will be there. Makeup water pump will be there. So condensate extraction pump is there. All these equipment for condensing plant for steam power plant. Condensing plant for steam power plant. Okay. And then hot well will be there and cooling tower will be there. So here, these are the equipment. Now we will see that what are the functions. We will see that earlier also we seen there for this diagram. Now we will once again we will see this diagram. So what is this diagram? So first of all, what you discussed till now, we are having one boiler as per the Rankine cycle PV diagram. Okay, as per PV diagram we are having one boiler. From the boiler we are going to generating that steam. That steam we are going to sending, or we are passing that steam to that it flows, that steam is going to be flows to that steam turbine, and steam turbine it is going to be taking place of mechanical work. After that, what is that remaining steam? That remaining steam we are going to sending to that condenser. Here is very clear cut line diagram I am showing. Please properly you please see that. Okay, from steam turbine, from that steam turbine that steam is going to be entering into that condenser, and that condenser the water will be the condensed. Okay, so that condensate that hot water, so that is coming over there again. What is that? Some of this what I mean to say, this condensate this that condensate we are going to extracting with this pump, and with this pump we are sending to that hot well. So over here the pump is going to be extracting that from condenser to hot well and sending to that hot well. So another same thing here, one more thing is there. When that steam is coming entering into that condenser, the condenser in that condenser, I told that very clearly, some of the steam will be there, and at the same time water will be there. That hot water we are going to sending to that cooling tower. See, cooling tower. So so in the cooling tower we are having that ejectors will be there. Ejectors means nozzles. Nozzles will be there. That nozzles is going to be spraying to that cooling water. So what is happening? So from that the air is going to be attacking, and that hot water is going to be becoming as a cooling water. Cooling water. So the air is going out from that cooling tower. So it is going to be coming, and with that water is also again we are going to extracting that water, and we are going to sending to that condenser. So if that over there that steam will be there again, that is going to be cooled. Entire that steam is going to be cooled, and it is going to be coming to that becoming as a water. See, my dear young friends, are you understand analysis? So that water again we are cooling water. Why we are doing all this thing? Why? What is the need to keep that condenser? Means that steam we have to convert into the water. Why? Because that we are going to wasting that steam, we are wasting that water. That's why the condenser will work over there in that steam. Okay, so after that it is going coming to that cold water. That cold water means almost all it is coming to that. If it is any steam will be there, that steam is also coming converted into that steam, converted into that steam. So that the steam is coming, condensate extraction pump. With that pump again we are going to sending that hot well. See, hot well. So up to that one more thing will be there. If any water is less, means it is not up to that mark level in that hot well, so one more we are arranged for water source from you can say that well, you can say that river. We are going to taking that water with the help of make water feed pump. So make up pump means we are going to make up in, we are going to maintaining that level of the water. That's why the pump is called as make up water pump. Okay, so again that make up water pump we are sending to that cold water. So this cold water, that cold waters combines and it is entering into that condenser. So what is there? If it is any steam will be there left out in that one. So it is coming automatically. So to that hot well. So no problem. Once it is coming to that hot well, again we are going to keeping economizers, super heaters. If you want to keep that water to be heated, we are going to keep in so many other pumps are there. Means other devices are there to generate that cold water into hot water. So over here one more. After that it is going to that boiler feed pump. Means why we are going to separatingly here three terms, so three pumps we are seeing. One is that condensate extraction pump, another one is make water pump, and cooling water pump. See that 1, 2, 3, 4 pumps are there here. Centrifugal pumps are there. See, clear? We studied that regarding about that analysis in centrifugal pumps in FM and H, fluid mechanics and hydraulic machinery. So that that is coming into that, and it is falling over there. So after that again that boiler water feed pump it will take, and the feed water is going to feed into the boiler. From that again same Rankine cycle. If you want to improve that methods, we can improve it. No problem for that one. We can improve that methods. So that is that one of the thing. Next. Another slide we can see that different types of condenser. I told that jet and surface condenser. Okay, jet and surface condenser. What are the types? We will see that jet condenser